second game is on. Gomez and Schumacher started what turned out to be one of the most one-sided slaughters in World Series history. With three on base in the first inning, Lou Gehrig banged a long fly to right field, and Crosetti crossed the plate with the first tally while DiMaggio held first base.
Gentle man. For many years, he played in the shadow of Ruth, the Phantom Star. Eternally, the Crown Prince, never the King. In a lesser man, resentment would have been routine, but Lou Gehrig was not that kind of a man.
.333 in the series, 5 for 15. Shoemaker on the mound. The line by the right-hander for the Giants, and here's the pitch. A swing and a drive. It's past Terry down the right field line, and it's getting away from Mott, and there goes Terry. Look at the iron horse gallop. He's around second. Terry on his way to third, and he steams in there. It's a single and an error by us. Hey, by the way, Casey Stengel just... First base, Lou Gehrig the batter. The pitch, and Gehrig swings a ground ball past Koenig. It's into center field for a base hit. DiMaggio the third, there's no one out, and that brings up Bill Dickey.
2,130 consecutive games played from 1925 through 1938. During his career, Lou set more than 20 Major League and American League records. He hit over 40 home runs five times, had 23 grand slams, hit four homers in one game in 1932, and batted in.
Here comes the next pitch. Over the plate, he hits a high fly back into right center field. It may be in. It's back, back, back. It's a home run. Lou Gehrig hit a home run into the stands in right center field.
Lou came to the Bronx Bombers directly from Columbia University, where he made the lion roar for 4 years as a student and athlete. Lou could hit and he could run. In this great shot, he homers to bring in Babe Ruth, who was his idol. Lou was a ball player's ball player. He gripped the bat through a record-breaking 2,170 consecutive games. A real pro, his batting stance was acclaimed by the old-timers and copied by the youngsters. His follow-through, in life as well as in athletics, made him one of the most idolized sports figures of the century.
Turns in the third inning when Gehrig slams the pill for a two-bagger after Ruth and Sewell have been put out.
Aches and pain. For Gehrig, it was mind over matter.
Says, well,
then slowing.
For 14 years, Lou Gehrig would be first baseman of the New York Yankees. He had place to his sportsmanship. For Lou Gehrig was genuinely a nice guy.
Soles, a long smash deep in the center field. Way up, going. A home run! Lou Gehrig. Boy, that was a strikeout.
Taken several doses of home run serum before these games, and it seems to be a scientific success as we again see the Yankee first baseman finishing another round trip with Ralph scoring ahead of him. Lou seems to be the home man of this series. He's always on his way home. Chalk up another game for the Yankees and make it 5-2.
Take a day off for the next 14 years. A lot of people still say he's the greatest first baseman of all time.
Davis threw a fat one to Gehrig, and Larrip and Lou belted a homer with the form that made him the idol of his day. Gehrig is one of the select circle honored in baseball's Hall of Fame, and this is one of the reasons why.
A broken thumb, a broken toe, and back spasms. Later in his career, Gehrig's hands were x-rayed, and doctors found 17 different fractures.
Lou Gehrig followed with a mighty home run drive far over the right field wall, scoring DiMaggio ahead of him, and the score is 2-0 in favor of the American League. They were never headed, the American League's All-Stars winning with a final score of 8-3. And so, another All-Star Classic has gone down in history.
For the past 2 weeks, you've been reading about a bad break. Today, I consider myself the luckiest man on the face of the earth. When you look around, wouldn't you consider it privilege to associate yourself with such a fine-looking man as is standing in uniform in this ballpark today?
That I might have been given a bad break, but I've got an awful lot to live for. Thank you.